the biggest limiting factor on AI is actually going to be power. The energy consumption necessary around AI, nobody has properly understood yet. And that's the one that I've been really, really obsessing about lately. Because Canada already is an 80% clean energy grid. It's a huge advantage. Companies from around the world are investing in Canada because of our clean energy, because of our workers, because of our innovation, all those things. But as we look at how to develop the necessary clean power to power AI, not just in Canada, but around the world, we've actually stepped up big time on nuclear. We just sold 2 full-scale reactors to Romania. Uranium reserves that we have in Canada, the opportunity to build full-scale reactors and small modular reactors to meet the energy needs of the coming years. Canada's been facing a massive boom of investment from around the world of companies that want to come into Canada. Some of you have heard of Honda, Volkswagen, Michelin, Goodyear. Others you haven't. And made Canada the number 3 destination in the world last year for foreign direct investment. A lot of it is because of the framework we have around environmental responsibility and clean power, but also because we have childcare and pharmacare and medical care and supports that are great for workers and benefiting from privileged access to 2/3 of the global economy through free trade deals. So all those things together means we're actually limited right now by the amount of power that we can provide to companies because so many people want to come to Canada. And that's where we're going to have to step up on nuclear and others to be able to respond to that. But I know, Mary, you've been on the gateway we're creating for the Indo-Pacific strategy.
We sure are. We're a tier one country for nuclear power. It's clean. And if we're going to meet our net zero targets, nuclear is going to be a part of the mix. We're launching a Canadian gateway for nuclear development for the Indo-Pacific, where many of the APEC economies are going to be a part of that. So we're really excited about doing this work to build that capacity.
So new nuclear power plants in Canada?
Canada developed CANDU reactors decades ago, particularly appreciated because you couldn't use a nuclear power plant to develop a weapons program if it was a Canadian one. It was just the way it was designed. That was very successful over a number of decades. We're now upgrading the CANDUs to MONARKs, more modern full-scale reactor, but we're also developing small modular reactors. Canada's actually got the first small modular reactors about to come online in the coming year, demonstrating a proof of concept. That's going to be an essential part of the energy mix that we have to have if we're going to meet the opportunities, not even the needs, the opportunities of the coming years.
It really is an end-to-end expertise, right? I mean, from the regulatory expertise that we have, building the nuclear reactors, to all of the training that comes in the supply chain that exists in Canada today, the end of use around the recycling, sharing that expertise. So it really is our ability as Canada to work with the region.
I bet you guys didn't think you were going to get a pitch on nuclear from Canada up here today. But these are the challenges that we're looking at and how to build a better world and how to make sure that energy is plentiful and affordable for everyone.
And your small reactors that can be exported could open data centers and create real value-added jobs. This is, you're exporting something which is of critical importance.
That something like 40% of people living on the African continent don't yet have reliable, steady access to electricity. And electricity has been around for a century and a half in its current form, in its generation. The first power plant in New York went up about 150 years ago. And still, 150 years later, this foundational technology of electricity hasn't reached everyone in the way that we know it will transform their lives.
Glenn McGregor, City News. You were asked yesterday at the CEO event about how you felt about building more nuclear reactors for domestic use in Canada. Could you maybe elaborate about how you feel about provincial governments increasing the number of nuclear facilities?
I think we are going to need significantly more baseload power in Canada if we're going to continue to draw in the kind of global investment we've been able to draw in around the world. Canada has increased its foreign direct investment by 60%. Since 2015. Last year, we were the 3rd destination country in the world for foreign direct investment, which means we were number 1 per capita in the G20. The world is interested in coming to Canada because we have some of the best workers in the world, we have the natural resources, we have trade deals with the world, and we have an 80% clean energy grid already. That is an extremely attractive proposition that countries and companies around the world want to be part of. But as we're drawing in these significant investments, whether it's Honda or Volkswagen or mining interests like Rio Tinto or others that are building up so much of our capacity to deliver to partners what the world needs from reliable, trustworthy sources, we're going to need more power. And we need that power to be as low emission as possible. Yes, we're phasing out our coal-fired power plants. We're looking for CCUS around our natural gas to abate the production. We're developing hydrogen solutions. We're investing in wind and solar and all sorts of different solutions. But we're going to need nuclear to be part of the mix. And I'm busy pitching nuclear energy around the world, have been for a number of years, which resulted in deals with Romania, not with just two new CANDU reactors, but refurbishing a number of existing reactors to extend their life. There is a real opportunity for Canada with both a vibrant nuclear industry that's innovating around small and modular reactors in a number of provinces, that's got a reliable source of uranium in Saskatchewan, that the world is looking to replace the Russian supply chains that are now uncertain for many. And people know that even though nuclear does come with real challenges, significant expense, long lead time to build them, if we want to keep drawing in investments and create opportunities for Canadian jobs, nuclear is going to have to be part of the mix. And I'm excited about that. I'm excited about the opportunities, and we're going to continue working with provinces. But it's not the federal government that decides where and when one builds power generation. But I can tell you I've had many conversations with a number of provinces about a nuclear being a solution, particularly in places where there is no hydroelectricity or hydroelectricity capacity is pretty close to maxed out.